All right, folks, welcome to another photo critique from the Digital Photo Rec Flickr group and posted on Facebook. I'm Toby.
And I'm Christina.
Of Christina Bernalis Photography. And...
duh.
Some people might not know that. And I should say that three things, folks. One, if you have posted your images on the Facebook for us to critique, you should have liked my page. I think you all have because you saw that I posted. Two, you should like Christina's page as well because she is bringing her knowledge and expertise to this podcast.
Only if you want.
Well, it's not a podcast. It's a critique.
No pressure.
Well, you have to. And you need to come over to youtube.com/user/camerarectoby and click the subscribe button, inching closer to 40,000 subscribers. I'd like to hit that number soon. And I'd really appreciate it if you would do that. It's an easy and free way for you to thank me, even if you never go to YouTube other than to watch these critiques. Take a moment. Hit that subscribe button. Tell your mom. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. Now.
My mom hit that subscribe button.
That just sounded bad.
It's true.
I know. My mom hit that.
My parents watched that.
I think we have to start the whole thing over.
Are you serious?
I do. That
no,
was,
it's fine.
It's
you
been
did
a little
a good
too
job.
Messy. It's a little too messy.
No, it's fine. People like it. Okay, moving on.
Okay. So I mentioned that we are going to touch on the 12 elements of a merit image tonight. We're really just going to touch on these. This is from PPA. What does PPA stand for, Christina?
Professional Photographers of America.
And you are, is it of America or is it association? Professional Photographers. I don't know.
I think it's of America.
You should know because,
here it is.
America, Professional Photographers of America. You are a member.
That's right.
What do you get as a member of PPA?
Well, you get lots of things. You get free equipment insurance, which is kind of like the big one for up to $15,000. You have to sign up for it, but you get it. Or rather, it's included in the price. You
right,
get,
because being, I'm sorry, being a member of PPA is not free.
Right, it is not free. You also get access to, I believe, legal advice, professionals who can... I don't know if this is one-on-one and if it's free because I've never actually reached out to anybody. But as far as I know, you have access to some legal advice and, you know, just advisors that can help you launch your business and or not launch your business, but can help answer questions that you might have along the way of running your business. So and obviously they have lots of other kinds of resources such as this that help photographers improve their craft, and they have, I believe they have, workshops. They sponsor workshops. They have competitions, like photo competitions, which are usually tied to workshops throughout the year where you can submit images and really have them critique. And if you think that we tear up images, then you must not have submitted any of your images and had them reviewed by one of these judges in one of these competitions because they truly, truly, truly are super nitpicky about everything.
Okay. They're probably following these 12 elements of a merit image.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. Very likely.
So, you know, they've been on the screen now for a few minutes, and I'm going to put a link down below to this, and we're not going to read through these. But I think some of you might be thinking, well, am I supposed to be thinking of each of these items as I bring the camera up to my each and every time I take a picture?
Yeah, pretty much.
I was going to say no.
No, you should. You should strive for this. I mean, I know that this is all very, very, you know, you can say that this kind of takes the fun out of photography because it doesn't, you know, yes and no. But if you're trying to, especially if you're being commissioned to do work for other people, or if you are trying to do this as a living or for a living or make money off of it, I think you should. You should follow these things. I think it's going to help you.
Yes, I'm sorry. I was just going to say that I don't think you should, in your mind, have to mentally check off 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, what? 5, 6. No,
sure.
But you know, when I bring the camera up to mine, here's what I do. I first make sure that technically I'm going to nail this image to the best of my ability. All right? So there are some of these that I have in my mind. And I think as we go through in future episodes and also in the podcast and in my, as I get my act together, the Think Before You Click series, really is going to touch on some of these. But, you know, technically I want to make sure my exposure is correct for the setting. I'm not always trying to create impact in an image and things like that. So I think there's some things that, you know, but then there are others. Christina's giving me a strange look.
Well, I think that at first these things will probably be something that you won't necessarily hit every time, all of these points, but they will become something that you are more intuitive about later on, and you just kind of have in the back of your mind and, you know, slowly just do them naturally.
Yep. You know what? This podcast or this critique has started off really boring. We're going to slide that over there because for 5 minutes now you've been staring at that screen. We're going to come up here and we're going to go to view into presentation mode. And I'll tell you what, I'm feeling a little picky tonight. But we also had several people who posted from the other, because I said, you don't have to follow all this.
Because I saw all of those.
Oh, no. Yeah, we have a lot to go through. I'm not sure we're going to get through all of them tonight. Oh, we're starting at the back end. But I'm feeling a little picky, and we have several people who have posted in the group and said, it's my first time posting. And you can hear the tone in their voice that says, be nice. And because we have a lot, I think we might try.
I think we're pretty nice.
Oh, I think we are. Yeah. Yes. But I think we will try a slightly different format and really kind of one thing we like or love about the image and maybe one thing that could make it a little stronger.
I like that. Yeah.
I don't know. We're not good at sticking to what we say, but...
but I like that. Let's challenge ourselves.
Yeah. And let's get the cursor out of the way on this horizon. So here we got a shot from Tom, Nantucket Sound, not too far from where we are, a few hours away. And I really like the simplicity of this image. I think that works really well. There's not much going on. Rocks and then water as far as you can see with a perfectly straight horizon. Actually, just maybe a little teeny bit of curvature from lens distortion, maybe. What are you shooting with? Yeah, at 11. And you probably corrected for that, but we still got a little bit there. What could make this better?
Well, what I like about this image is the symmetry. I think that's very, very cool. What I think could be better about this image is this reflection right here. It just kind of takes away from this. It keeps bringing my eye back to it. I realize that this might be the sun or the moon. It's very cool, but I just don't think... Again, we want to be focused right here in all the detail and all the, the snow and even this right here. I don't want my eye to be. So maybe do a little Photoshop if you can. And just
flip it?
Yeah, flip it and copy and paste. I think that would be okay. Just to kind of, you know, if we go back to that list presentation, if you just retouched it. This isn't like a photojournalistic picture. So, yeah, that's my one.
Okay.
Improvement.
Now, it might be hard to flip that and get it to look natural. I just say it, I believe it is the moon because we were dealing with a 15-second exposure here.
Yeah.
Scott captured a moment. He hardly had any time to react, but here is Tiger's Chet Lemon giving his son a baseball. So, you know, in these kind of capture-the-moment shots, when you have very little time, it's tough. I think the colors in this are great. The lighting is good. Could be exposed a little brighter because I don't see anything about to get blown out so that his face, which is under the brim of that hat, could be a little bit exposed nicer. And if you lean to the right a little bit, maybe he wouldn't be intersecting that one building that's sticking up back there as much. But it's pretty minor. Also see that you're in manual mode. You're all the way up at ISO 1600. Shooting at 1/1600th of a second, you can certainly have dropped that and gotten a little bit of a cleaner image, but the noise is pretty hidden in this because the exposure is in good shape.
So one thing I really like about this image is you've got this guy, and then you've got this guy, and then you've got this guy, and then you've got this guy. I think he's framed, while I don't love the intersection of his head with the building, I recognize that this was, you know, like in the moment, and you may not have had the opportunity to get this shot if you had moved elsewhere. But I love how he is framed between these people. I think that's very, very cool. One thing that I would change about this image is the vignette. I'm not loving the vignette. I think it doesn't look super natural. you know, it's just a little too much. Maybe tone it down just a touch, but that's it.
Great. Thanks, Scott. It's a nice flower photo. I think ennui photography. I think we've critiqued some of your images before. Definitely recognize your name. It's nice.
I don't think it's not super fresh and new. It's not something that we've never seen before.
Yeah, it's flowers on a stalk. Yeah. They're very pretty flowers, but there's a lot of them, and they're all just kind of right there.
Yeah. The composition is good. I mean, I can clearly see that this is the focal point.
Mm-hmm.
And there's nothing that really distracts my eye in such a way that, like, I don't come back to this.
Yep.
So I like the composition. I like the aspect ratio. But I don't really have much. I would say white balance is off. It looks very, very blue to me.
Mm.
I would say fix the white balance.
Yep. Technically, it's good. F4. And this may be a spot where you could have gone to a shallower depth of field and really isolated the one that was your subject. And let the other ones fall, be a little bit softer, even softer. So it doesn't feel, it feels a little busy to me. That's what I'll say. All right. Thank you. Dustin. Now, do you remember where we've seen Dustin's work before?
No.
He had his wife doing that crazy yoga shot.
Oh, right. Oh, right. Wow.
Yep. So now we got a CrossFit trainer session.
This is very cool.
It is. It's a cool shot. It almost looks like a set, but I don't think so. I think it's outside at lower light levels, and you're using a flash. And let's take the mouse off his body.
Very curious about how this image was made, because on the one hand, you did not use high-speed sync, and the space looks quite dark. So was it, like, dark there?
I think so.
Oh, and you just had a flash lighting up the background? Wow, this is, and I think technically it's really, really well done. Very, very nice. I would say the white balance on his face is a little off. I think his nose is a little too magenta. It looks like it may have been a little cold, but you could just fix that. You should fix that. The nose, and then there's some magenta here on the knees.
Yeah.
So I might just fix that.
And then the background feels a little green to me.
Yes, it does.
So I think we do have some kind of coloring going there.
But you may have wanted to do that, so...
I think so, because it feels to me like kind of this, Hawaiian jungle. Dustin, I think you were in California, if I remember correctly. But it feels like this kind of Hawaiian jungle look that you're going for. This, you know, strong guy with tropical-looking tattoo thing. Here in this wild place.
Yep. Nicely done.
I think nicely done. You know, getting really picky. This log being brightly lit so much keeps catching my eye back there. And then if we want to talk about grass again, we got that little bit of grass, but I don't want you to tear it up. Maybe just put a rock on it temporarily. But that's minor. It really is. But it is catching the light.
The stick, actually, now that you pointed it out, doesn't seem that minor. I feel like you should have...
Yeah.
How do you
it's not a
that?
Stick. It's a big log, right?
Right.
It's not something easy in the reflection of it, too.
Right.
Maybe to shoot him on this side and get the light over there.
Anyway, thanks for submitting.
Yep. John has a really pointy fence.
Yeah. This is, again, in terms of technical abilities, I think this is well done. I don't think it's anything really that special. I feel mean saying that.
Well, I know. I think this is a shot that I would like to try. I would take two. I would see this fence and I'd be like, ooh, I got, a nice lens here. I'm going to do a really shallow depth of field and have this repeat. But I think I would try two different options. Is either go for it. Go all the way to the right where you're shooting right down the fence. That is, and these points are repeating right into infinity distance. And your view, and be narrow. You're shooting at 57. You could have gone up to 70 in that case. At 1 second, you had a tripod. I'm going to assume you had a tripod.
I like the focal length. I don't love all this negative space.
Yeah.
This is...
Yeah, and that one bright light there catches the eye.
Yeah.
What I was going to say is the other option is to hit this directly, parallel to the fence, where you just pick like five of the spines, there they are right in front of you, boop, 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 sharp focus with the soft focus back behind them. Yeah. So you don't get the repeating.
That could work.
That's, I think, would be interesting subject here.
Yeah. Thanks for submitting, John.
Yep.
Oh, this is something I haven't seen in a while.
Oh, we haven't seen a fireworks picture. We're probably going to see a lot more as summer comes on.
Oh, right.
Now, we're going to be quicker with some of these than others, simply because I know we've critiqued your images before, mm-hmm. and we try to get to folks that haven't been critiqued. I think this is great. Fireworks can be a little tricky to capture, but this is a nice 4-second exposure, gave you a nice amount without too much. This little bit of horizon line, crooked, I think actually adds to it.
Yeah.
It makes it a little bit more dynamic. But these buildings right here,
yeah.
get rid of them. Photoshop them out, Lightroom them, clone stamp them out. They yeah. don't add anything at all, and that would be really easy to fix.
A little bit of scale, but I don't know.
You know, it's confusing scale, too, because they're way back there. Oh, look, and we have one intersecting the light. Yeah. I actually didn't notice that, so it's not as big a deal. But those just floating out there like little two alien eyeball stalks.
I like the composition, but I love those guys.
Yep, great. Now, Catherine, she's a relatively new follower. We've been talking about some different lens options, I think. Sweet, sweet picture.
I like this picture a lot.
First thing I noticed, though, is shooting at the shallower depth of field, the wrong eye is in sharper focus.
Yeah.
We got the close eye here to us is just a little bit soft. It looks like focus gets sharp right about here out to here. And then, of course, we don't know because then it's lost into a deeper background.
Yeah.
But better would be all of this in focus. But if you had to pick just one, the closer eye.
Yeah, I don't think that was on purpose, though. I think babies move really fast.
Yep, it's true.
But yeah, it's true. I mean, if you're working with a person where you have like full control over their movements, then I would say definitely the closest eye should be in focus.
Yep.
But I think this is a lovely portrait of a baby. I think if I were to change anything, it would be the white balance. White balance is really blue and really magenta.
You sound a little like a broken record.
Not really magenta. Just, well, I mean,
You're very
picky. This is the new horizon.
The new
crooked horizon
line. I think we made that joke already.
Did we?
I don't know. I'll just add that you could shoot this at a larger aperture, which means, you know, smaller f, like f3.2 or even f4. To really get the baby sharp, and that background is still going to be very soft because of the distance between your subject yeah. and the baby. So that would be safe to do.
But lines could become a little bit harder, which might distract a little bit from
true.
The baby.
That's so. True, yeah. But your lighting here is great. I see that off in the distance you have very bright, harsh light. But here in the shade,
yes.
you've got really nice light. It's coming in from a good direction.
Yes.
Nicely done, Catherine. Catherine's got another one real quick, so we don't do too often, but I'll just say, put the baby to the right a little bit more so it's not intersecting that bush back there.
And the coloring is off in this one.
I think...
It's desaturated.
Yes, I would say that it's desaturated, and I don't think it looks very good that way. I think that it looks better closer to natural back there. Thank you, Catherine. JCB, regular follower. It's gorgeous. Very nice lighting, very nice colors. Being super picky, I might say that this little bit of brighter light up here is distracting. But otherwise, I think this is a nice shot.
Yep, white balance is good too.
I mean, it's a little easier with flowers and other things. Another one from JCB, again, that 100mm lens, beautiful. Look at that detail.
Yeah, that's crazy cool.
You put them on the right, leaning in, really nice job, works good. Look, oh. One more bug right there hiding. Little aphid.
Ah, that's cool. Mm.
Jonathan Hill. Now, I got a soft spot for flowy water pictures.
Yes, you do.
I love them. I think they're great. Two quick things that jump out at me in this image, though, is my eye keeps coming right here.
And mine goes, like, right here and then back up to the trunk,
yeah.
up the trunk.
So we need a little bit less of tree and trunk. Those roots are cool. I think they can be used to frame part of this image, but right now that's in sharp focus and it's coming towards us, it's coming towards my eye, and it's taking away from this. Second thing I notice is your watermark. It's fine. It's a subtler one. It's certainly not terrible. But because it's so, I hate that URL comes up every time I move the mouse on there. Because it's so close to the edge, and maybe I'm just a dummy, But the first couple times I looked at it, I thought, oh, did I screw up and load this half or something? And I thought maybe there was more to the left of this image, also because of the framing, because I thought maybe that, you know, we're missing the J or some other letter over here.
Yeah, I see what you're saying.
So give your, if you want to do watermarks, give your watermark just a little bit more breathing room so it's not touching the edge.
Yep. Cool. Good technical skills, so in getting the flowy waterfall. I think that's cool. And I do think it's a very, very pretty picture.
Yep. I love this time of year. I think this is, you probably live somewhere around the East Coast, I'm going to guess. Oh, actually, we know. I know where you live, roughly, or at least where you took the next picture.
You know where he lives.
I know where you live, Jonathan. Way to creep people out. Great Falls, Maryland.
Oh, I know where you live, too.
This one's, okay. So, I feel like I've been talking a lot. You okay with that?
I'm fine with that.
I love, this is a super long exposure. You must have used an intervalometer of some sort, 150 seconds. And I love what it's done to the sky. I have not taken a picture like this yet. And it's in my mind that I really want to take a moment to find a place to do that. Because I really love the fact that instead of the flowy water, although we have that below, we have flowy clouds. So we're seeing the motion in the clouds blurring, plus that those colors coming up. Really has created this cool scene. Now, that's all good. Christina?
I don't love the composition so much. I think that this could be maybe cropped here a little bit. But I do love the colors and I do love the long shutter speed.
Okay. I'll just say that I down here, this is not doing much for me. Got a stick. It's getting very noisy. It's
dead space right in the lower left. Dead space. Right corner.
Your watermark feels bigger and brighter against this darkness down here. I think this image would be great. Just the tree line and the above. Moving on. Thank you, Jonathan.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's nice to have it a little different.
Yeah.
William, it's got this Audi.
Looks like it.
Audi.
A little bit of a panning photo, right?
It does. It did look like that to me as well. My first thought was, I wish there was more to give it the sense of panning and movement. Mm-hmm. What we're talking about is that these areas look a little soft here, but the car looks pretty sharp, meaning so William was moving the camera as the car went by at some high speed. Can I just say these cars look freaking awesome? I'm not a car person, but golly, it looks like a spaceship. Pew!
You should watch Formula One then. You would like it. You always poo-poo it.
All right, well, we can discuss that further later. Let's just say that I think this is a really nice image. The angle works well for me. The little bit of motion, I wish there was a little bit more to show more motion. But I think it's nice.
I like it. I think it's good.
Okay.
I like the simplicity of just, like, the lines and not a ton of colors. And yeah.
Yep, that's true. That works really well. Nice job, William. Thank you. Now, Terry... we're going to go back one more. Terry thought we were doing the assignment.
Oh, the symmetry one?
Yeah.
Oh,
no, not the symmetry. The new one. And we're not yet, Terry. But I left both of these in this because I think this is the start of a great illustration. So a quick recap of the assignment is go out there, find some scene, and capture it. Then within that scene, really pick a subject and focus in. Now, here's something. I would walk up to this and be like, wow, this is cool. This temple with all of these carvings and all of these idol bits and stuff down below. And you would be likely to kind of like take a picture of it. But I think his next shot, illustrating what we're asking, this is a really strong shot, much stronger. Because it really focuses in on that statue. And we have the repetition of the arms and all of the details, but I really like this. So I think this is great. It looks a little soft to me, but 1/8 of a second. So I think you're starting to get down into handshake territory, even with the image stabilization.
You could have brought your ISO up a little bit.
That's right. Definitely can go on up 200, 400 and been safer there. But I think this is a great illustration. So, Terry, thank you for putting it in there. Here's the whole scene. Interesting, but not a strong image. This is a strong image. Thank you, Terry. Kyle's got barge on the canal.
This image is just a little too busy, and there's no real focal point. Like, is the focal point this tree, or is the focal point the boat? And there's all of this dead space here that's just not really working for me that much.
Yeah, I think this is neat. I'd love to go for a ride on one of these canals, but I want to see, and it may not be possible at this point, but I want to see the canal stretching off into the distance, or at least around a curve. And this is really just kind of almost looks like it just be a pond here. And we're not really getting a sense of the barge, just the back of it. And I'm kind of saying what Christina said in a different way. So I agree. But I think this could have potential. Thank you, Kyle. Alan has stumbled across a Twilight Lake venue in the woods. This looks to me like a setup for kind of one of those rustic chic weddings. Chic? Mm-hmm. Chic.
Yes. I don't love that the closest table is out of focus, whereas like the furthest table is in focus. I think either have everything in focus or have the closest thing, because that's where the eye naturally goes, is whatever's closest. And if it's out of focus, it's kind of distracting. But otherwise, I think the composition is pretty nice. I feel like the scene's kind of a tough scene to photograph. I mean, I've been there. And
you've been to the spot?
No, not to this. I mean, I've been in a situation like that. And there's just so many lines and so many different elements that, like, it can feel super crowded and busy. But I think you did well with this.
Yeah. I'd say that also, you know, the heater sticking up here right in the middle. I know there's probably another one here.
And yeah,
another.
There's yeah. No
so
way
there's
out
a lot
that.
Of them. But this may be a place, this follow that rule of, you know, narrowing in on a subject within this space, and you may come out with a stronger image. Robert's got an abandoned house.
In Japan.
In Japan. This might be one where I say, pull back a little bit. Give us more of a sense of the place. Because what I'm seeing here is interesting in the vines on the windows and roof and overgrown grass. But it almost feels like too little. And I want a little bit more.
Yeah, the composition is good. I think the window is, you know, nicely framed. But otherwise, there's not really that much interesting to me about this image, other than it's in Japan, and I want to go to Japan. But I wouldn't have known that if you hadn't written it in the description. So, yep. Thanks for submitting, Robert.
All right. Thanks for watching. We're going to follow this up with part two next week. And as I said, please subscribe, give our pages a like, and keep on taking those photos and keep submitting them. As I've said before, we recognize it's not easy to put your work out here in front of people and have us pick at it and say the magenta and say crooked and things like that. But it helps you. It helps us. And thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.